Thank you. city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly hosts of the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Amen. change. Why aren't there armed guards trying to break down the doors to come in and break up our celebration today? Honestly, it was the large number of Irish and German immigrants who came over to the United States in the middle of the 19th century. They came from parts of Europe where the puritanical sort of oppression was not taking place, and so they retained their religious celebration of this feast. And when they came over to the United States, they brought with them their religious traditions and symbols. They set up lights and decorated trees. They put out nativity scenes and sang carols and hymns which sang of the glory of this holy feast that we are celebrating. They celebrated masses, they abstained from works, they threw parties, and they sang hymns and carols and invited their neighbors and friends all to come to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, God made flesh to save us. And what happened was, because of their witness, their neighbors started to take notice. I'm going to work on Christmas, my kids are going to school, you know, they're having a party over here, what's that all about? I want some of that. And little by little, because of the witness of these Irish and German immigrants, they began to win over their neighbors, who began to come to their parties, who began to join in their festivities, learn their hymns and songs and customs, and learn the reason for all of this frivolity. The reason that we have to be joyful today and why we should celebrate today this great feast of Christmas. Well, my brothers and sisters, isn't that really just the story of Christmas playing itself out again? That God enters into our lived experience to fix what is broken, to remind us of who He is and who we are, and to fix our eyes once again on what truly matters, Jesus Christ. But that little historical vignette also reminds us that this story of Christmas is not merely relegated to 2,000 years ago in Bethlehem. It's not a one-time occurrence. Rather, this spiritual pattern where God enters in order to fix what is broken, to remind us of who He is and who we are, and to fix our eyes once again on what truly matters, Jesus Christ, is something that is meant to repeat itself over and over again in our lives. And for us as Catholics, this happens in a unique and powerful way every time we come to receive the Holy Eucharist. Because at Mass, once again, God is made man. God becomes flesh among us in the most holy Eucharist and gives Himself to us for the healing of our body and soul. Gives Himself to us to strengthen and nourish us. Gives Himself to us so we might share more fully in His divine life and glory. The same Jesus Christ who was coddled in the arms of the Blessed Virgin Mary on that first Christmas in Bethlehem is the same God who places Himself into your hand every time you come forward to receive the Holy Eucharist. And He gives Himself to you for that same reason, that the Christmas story might once again be repeated in your life. That as you receive Him, He might enter into your lived experience to fix what is broken, to remind you who He is and who you are, and to once again fix your eyes on who truly matters, Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters, the Lord enters into your life also so that you might go out into the world and through you He might enter into the lives of others so that they too might experience the Christmas story in their own lives. That in their life God might enter in to fix what is broken, to remind us of who He is and who you are, and to once again fix our eyes on what truly matters, Jesus Christ. My friends, we celebrate today, and we rightly should, and we should allow others to see us celebrating this great and holy feast. And we should invite others to join in our festivities, and when they do, to tell them why we are celebrating today. Today we are celebrating God made man among us in order to redeem us. Today we are celebrating Jesus Christ's true and real presence with us in the Christmas mystery and in the Eucharist. Today we celebrate that Christmas story that once again plays itself out in our life as God enters into our lived experience. Fix what is broken, to remind us of who He is. That's it, and Merry Christmas. I hope you celebrate with great frivolity today and let others see the joy on your face. And do not be afraid to tell them why you are celebrating and filled with joy.
Thank you.
so that it may be